three for a occupation GI blues. From my GI head to the heels of my GI shoes.
Hey guys, so welcome to another Elvis History vlog series. This is episode 2. Now, I did put a poll out to see which one would get the most votes, and it came down to two places. It came down to Graceland and Elvis's time in Germany and where he lived in Germany. So I've decided to do this into two different episodes. So this is episode 2, and originally episode 2 was supposed to be about Graceland, but I've done a switcheroo. I've switched them around. So this is about Elvis's life in the army and in Germany. So if you bear with me, I'm looking forward to doing this one. But it probably will be quite a long video. I've put it into 4 different sections. So the first part is when he first gets the letter about being drafted into the army. So on December the 20th, 1957, Elvis received a letter to be drafted into the army. He received this news while spending the Christmas holidays at Graceland with his mum, his dad, Vernon, and his girlfriend at the time, Anita Wood. And you can imagine just how he felt, but obviously he knew he was getting this letter, and how he felt when he opened it, and how I can imagine how his mum would have felt about him receiving this over the Christmas period. So Elvis served in the army from 1958 through 1960, and he served in the Unit Headquarters Company A, 1st Medium Tank Battalion, 2nd 32nd Armour Regiment, and the 3rd Armoured Division. Excuse me. So that's just the first part, and I think the fact that he managed to serve his full 2 years is incredible. Even though I know he struggled so much before going into the army, he lost a great part of his life, unfortunately. And unfortunately, that is also going to be in this vlog too. So this is where it comes down to the pre-induction, before actually having going off to do his proper induction. So we all know Colonel Tom Parker. He was aware that Elvis had been drafted and how it would affect his career. And in my opinion, it probably did affect his career at the beginning, but after coming out of the army, I think it boosted his career even more, because he came back more respected, more understood, and more welcomed after he'd served his time and served his country. And you can imagine how the parents of all these young girls would finally see what an amazing young man and amazing young person he became while serving in the army. So on the 4th of January 1957, Elvis attended the Kennedy Veterans Hospital in Memphis for his pre-army induction medical. That building is still up and is still in Memphis today. So on January 8th, on Elvis's 22nd birthday, he was declared 1A, which probably means like really fit and physically fit, by the Memphis Draft Board. Physically fit and likely to be drafted in the next 8 months. The 16th of December was officially declared that Elvis would receive his draft letter. So that would explain the reason why he got it over on the 20th of December, over the Christmas period, bless him. The army did offer Elvis to tour the world, visiting troops in different places in hopes to boost the morale and encourage other young men to enlist in the army. Elvis decided to join the army as a regular soldier. He didn't want the high star treatment. He wanted to be treated like every other soldier. Now that just says something about him to me. It just says that he's a well-mannered young person. He doesn't want to be treated any differently than what other people would. Whereas a lot of people these days, if they're a well-known artist or actor, then some who do go in the army, unfortunately, do get the specialised treatment, but it just goes to prove that he didn't want that. And I love that about Elvis. I just think that's so down to earth of him to choose that route. And we all know how Colonel Parker is. He's a bit of a spoon. And what I've come to learn of him, I don't really like Colonel Parker. He had too much control over Elvis's finances, over his decisions, over his life, and over the movie sector of his life too. So Elvis was originally supposed to be drafted on the 20th of January 1958. However, due to the commitments at Paramount Pictures and the filming schedule for his latest film, which was King Creole, Elvis had to personally write a letter to the Memphis Draft Board to request a different deferment, which means a different date to be drafted. Now we're getting from the pre-induction to the actual induction, which is the army life beginning of it. So, 2 weeks after finishing King Creole, Elvis reported for his induction on the 2nd of March, or 24th of March 1958. Elvis was given a physical and assigned army number 533-10761. After goodbyes to his family and his friends, he gets on the bus to take that takes him to Fort Chaffee, which is in Arkansas. I know that sounds really weird coming from an English person. It's, from what I've heard, it's called Arkansas. Oh, not Arkansas. Arkansas. I've got it so wrong, I do apologise for my naming of American states in the US. I should get better practice on them. Trust me to do that halfway through a vlog. And this is then once he arrives at Fort Hood. Elvis spent roughly about 4 days at Fort Chaffee after then being sent to Fort Hood in Texas. After being assigned to Company A of the 3rd Armoured Division, 1st Tank Battalion, Elvis completed his training by June. And Elvis become a pistol sharpshooter and expressed enjoyment of the rough and tumble of the tank obstacle course. Now, that definitely seems like Elvis to me, having a good old time. Been chucked here and over a rough and tumble of a tank. Obviously, I don't know what it was like. I don't know what it's like to be in a tank. I think I'd probably find it a bit hard to be in such a small space, but you can just imagine the laughter, the jokes that he would have come up with. So, unfortunately, this next part, after that part, would have been where his mum had started going downhill with her health. And I hate talking about this. I do feel to this day so bad that his mother passed the way that she did and that he didn't get much time to be with her or have much time grieving. So, in early August, while in Texas with her son, Gladys was taken ill. She had upped her taking alcohol and was also taking diet pills alongside the alcohol and also was on a pretty bad diet. But these pills were her attempt to lose weight. But to me, she was perfect the way she was. She was just that huggy, cuddling, loving type of mother. And it didn't matter about her weight to me. And unfortunately, she didn't obviously enjoy being that way. With a bad diet that led to the deterioration of her liver, The next day, Gladys collapsed from exhaustion after having an argument with Vernon. But Elvis arranged for his mum and dad to head home to Memphis on the 8th of August. And this is where it starts taking quite a bad turn. And I so wish this didn't happen. I wish they'd called it earlier, then maybe she could have been saved. So the day after returning home, Gladys's condition grew far worse, and then she was admitted to Memphis Baptist Hospital. The 11th of August, Elvis requested an emergency leave to visit his mum. We know how the army can be. They didn't listen to him on the first day, but on August 14th, and threatening to go AWOL, Elvis was granted to leave and given permission on the 12th of August to go and visit his mum. So once he came home, he went straight to the hospital with his dad and went to visit his mum. And we all know how close Elvis was with his mum. They had a real tight bond that gives most of us the feels that we want that as well during these days. And I'm lucky to have quite a close, tight-knit relationship with my mum, although we sometimes have arguments, but all mums, sons and daughters do. And I believe it would have been August 13th during that night, or going into August 14th, he went home and got changed, had a bite to eat and fell asleep. And it would have been during that time, Elvis would have found and got the news that his mum had unfortunately passed away. Now, I've done a bit of research on what she actually passed away from. I read it was a heart attack, that it was from acute hepatitis, but this is where I got it from, that she passed away from cirrhosis, from the liver, from drinking. And obviously, when he found out the news, him and his father were completely and utterly devastated, and I can so understand that. And they were offered an autopsy, but they declined. They didn't want to go through with that, and that I can completely understand, because that would have completely put Elvis in more of a depressed state than what he had already gotten into, unfortunately. So August 15th was the day of the funeral, and Elvis, before the funeral started, collapsed several times. Not only before, but during the funeral and after. Now, during the funeral, people had to hold him back from jumping into the grave with his mum, with his mum's coffin. And I also looked up that he had to be sedated because of how upset and devastated he was. And I can understand that, because he literally just lost his best friend and the most important person in his life, which is your mum. And he was only supposed to be there till the 18th of August, and then he got an extra 5 days to grieve, but that wasn't enough time for Elvis to grieve over his mum. He then had to leave Memphis and go straight back to Fort Hood in Texas on the 25th of August. Now we're reaching 1958, where it was the beginning of his journey from the US over to Germany. So in 1958, after his training at Fort Hood, Elvis was assigned to the 1st Medium Tank Battalion, 32nd Armour, 3rd Armoured Division. in Freiburg, West Germany. Elvis left Fort Hood on the 19th of September, and he arrived in New York, ready for the boat that would take him to Germany on the 22nd of September. During the crossing, Elvis met and made a friend called Charlie Hodge. And we all know Charlie Hodge. Some of the stories he's told over the years about him and Elvis were just so hilarious. And where Charlie is holding the microphone for Elvis on stage. And he would become a real close friend to Elvis during the army and after the army and up until Elvis's death in 1977. And we know how the story goes from him staying at the Ray Barracks in Germany. He wanted a bit more privacy. He wanted to have a house for his family, for while his family were there with him. So he looked around and finally found the perfect house, which was in Bad Nauheim, which is a close town to Freiburg, which is 14 Goethestrasse Avenue or Road in Bad Nauheim. And then on September 13th, 1959, Elvis met Priscilla Ann Bolio during a party at Bob's home. People said that as soon as Elvis saw sight of Priscilla, he immediately took a liking to her. And from the stories that I've heard and studies that I've done and the research, he acted like like a teenager again, as most young men do these days when they see someone that they like. Later on, the pair would become inseparable. She was there for him. He told her things. He could turn to her and speak to her about the things that he was going through. She wasn't only a friend, but she would later, after several years, become his wife. The only person to marry Elvis. And later they would come to have a beautiful, beautiful daughter, Lisa Marie Presley, who would unfortunately come to lose her father due to health issues and drugs that he didn't actually need to have. And on March 24th, 1958, Elvis received an award, or was awarded, the Army Good Conduct Medal. He also qualified as an expert marksman with several different weapons. Now you can imagine that, trying to run from Elvis and him just being, boom, got you. Hence why I'm so quick with his guns and the fireworks. He also changed ranks. On March 24th, 1958, he started off as a private. On November 27th, 1958, he was upgraded to private first class, which is awesome. And then on the 1st of June, 1959, he became a specialist fourth class. And on the February 11th, 1960, he was then upgraded to a sergeant, which is also so cool. I mean, come on. But before Elvis moved into 14 Goethestrasse Avenue, the house in Bad Nauheim, he first started living at the Hilberts Park Hotel in Bad Homburg. Sounds like Bad Homburg, but it's not. And after a few weeks staying there, he then moved into the Grunwald Hotel in Bad Nauheim. And from there, he then moved into 14 Goethestrasse Street, which is, the house is still there to this day, and many, many Elvis fans go and visit that area where he lived, where he stayed for the 2 years that he was inducted into the army. Sorry about that, my dog's growling. And then he had an honourable discharge. He went in into the army as a private and came out a sergeant, which I think is a huge, huge accomplishment for Elvis. And of course he was excited to, once he left the airport in Germany, he actually landed at an airport in Scotland, which is quite cool. He met some Scottish fans, and I wish that he'd gotten the chance to travel around the UK quite a bit. I think he would have really, really, really enjoyed the sights. And of course, the ladies. He is quite a ladies' man, as we all know. And I think he just overall would have enjoyed it, especially the food. We know he was a huge foodie, and we know that for a fact. And yeah, so that concludes this week's vlog of Elvis's life, not only in Germany, but going through a horrible thing that none of us should ever have to have gone through, which was losing his mum. But he came out more respected, more understanding. When he went into the army, and yeah, so I'm hoping you guys. We also, alright, give me a moment. Sorry, this is the other part of the vlog that I had to sort of finish. He also came out more respected, in my opinion, and such an amazing person. He definitely changed mother's opinions on him, I think, in it. People said it would ruin his career, and he thought that. To me, personally, I think it improved his career in a lot of ways, and unfortunately, some in not so many ways. So yeah, I'm hoping we also reached 6K, and oh my gosh, when I started doing this channel, I honestly never thought that we'd get that far, and I'm so grateful that us as the whole Elvis family, you guys are enjoying these vlogs. You're enjoying the videos and the content that I'm posting, and I just want to thank you all so much for the support that you're giving this channel. And please continue to like, share, comment and subscribe. Just share this channel with your friends, your family, whoever you know who is an Elvis fan, and just continue to share the legacy and love of Elvis that he was, the person that he is continuing to be today. And I love you guys. Please stay safe. And I'm also working on a second vlog this evening. So thank you guys. I love you and stay safe. I got 1, 2, 3 for a occupation GI Blue. GI Blue. GI Blue. From a GI.